As most of you probably know, I've been playing a lot of Elite Dangerous lately. I really enjoy the game, so been playing that a lot. But there are people who like to complain. I'm one of them. You know, it's a pot calling the kettle black. You know, I complain a lot. But it's kind of my job. My job is to complain. I make a very low-paying job, granted, but it's a job. I get paid. New chair? Nope, same chair, just without the headrest. Yeah, people have been complaining about Elite Dangerous, especially on their forums. And I found it interesting. Because I want to go over some of the complaints I've been hearing. And one of the more interesting arguments that, not specific to Elite, but in gaming or in things in general, I should say. It doesn't even necessarily mean about gaming, but just things in general. One of the trends I've seen happen is people will say something like this. They'll say, "This game is boring." And the thing about that opinion, as opposed to just about any other opinion, is that you don't have to back it up. Right? That's one of those opinions that people can just say. And if you ask them why, like, okay, well, why do you find this game boring? Oh, I just do. I just do. And to me, that's a very piss poor argument, you know. With just about any other claim that's an opinion, typically you have to back up your point, otherwise it's generally a piss poor argument. So, like, for example, if you say something like, "I think that Coca-Cola is a bad soda," you know, people say, "Well, why do you think that?" And then you're gonna expect to give a reason. "I think that this movie is overrated." Okay, well, why do you think that? But very often, especially when it comes to video games, people will often bring up the point of, "Well, I find the game boring, therefore equal bad." No. You can't. That is not a proper. That is not a proper argument. Let's go on the pretense. You say you think this game is boring, whatever game it is. Okay, so you're playing The Sims, or you're playing World of Warcraft, or you're playing Bejeweled, whatever the game is you're playing. What you think a game like that is boring? Why? What about the gameplay do you find boring? Well, there isn't anything to do. There isn't anything to do, right? Or there's not enough to do. And when it comes to Elite on their forums, often the argument is there's not enough to do. Or there's nothing to do, therefore boring. It reminds me of the same argument that a person makes when they open up their refrigerator full of food and say, "There's nothing to eat." We're all guilty of it. You go to your fridge, open up the refrigerator, look inside, you go, "Pfft, there's nothing to eat," and you close the fridge. Meanwhile, the fridge is stocked full of food. The correct statement would be, "There's nothing I want to eat." Not that there's nothing to eat at all. Okay, that's an incorrect statement. There's plenty to eat in your refrigerator. Unless you're very, very poor or you have a very empty fridge. Like I used to be. I'm still kind of that poor, but I was way more poor than I am now, when my fridge had like maybe some milk and a stick of butter. And then I can make the statement, Even then, there's really nothing to eat. Now, there's butter. You could eat the butter. I don't recommend it, but... But the statement that, oh, there's nothing to do, you know. Oh, there's nothing to do. No, no, no. That's an incorrect statement. There's nothing that you want to do. Okay? That's your issue. But one of the things I noticed is this. After playing Elite Dangerous for roughly a month now, it's been about a month, I would say that Elite Dangerous is the kind of game that any diehard role player out there should be creaming their pants over. Because it is precisely what it's designed for. Now let me explain. In Elite Dangerous, there are tools put in place that allows the player to perform certain tasks. So, for example, one of the things in the game are slaves. That's a commodity. That's an item that you can find and or buy. And when you do that, you can then engage in trading with said commodity. Now, that commodity can be anything from tea to gold to weapons to slaves. Now, from a numerical point of view, from a technical point of view, there is no difference other than the price tag and the legality within the context of the game for these items, okay? And the label associated with it. This particular commodity happens to have the label of slaves, and it's worth X, and it's marked illegal, yes or no. That's on the technical level. So if you were to look at a database of items, slaves is there, and it has certain flags set. Okay, this is this price, it has this label, and it has this condition. Whereas coffee would have this label, has this price tag, and it has this condition. Graphically, there's no difference other than the label. But if, say, you're in Elite and you're playing as a smuggler, and you want to smuggle goods into a station, which makes for a better story? There I was, flying through the deepest, darkest recesses of outer space in my space hauler, and all of a sudden the cops showed up around the corner. I quickly hit the silent running, and I quickly went into stealth mode, hoping they didn't see my ship floating like a hunk of trash in space as I floated carelessly but aimfully towards the port of the starport I was going to land at. Hauling behind me was a plethora of highly illegal coffee beans. These coffee beans are wanted throughout the universe, the galaxy. And I was going to make sure my delivery was on time, hauling my illegal stash of contraband coffee beans. Or, there I was, flying through space, and all of a sudden, police showed up out of nowhere. I hit the silent running on my ship as I floated aimlessly towards the station, hoping I didn't ram into the side of the station, when all of a sudden I realized my 12 tons of slave cargo was in jeopardy of costing me a load of money. Now, which do you think makes for a better story? Hauling and smuggling coffee or hauling and smuggling slaves? Again, Han Solo was a badass character because he was a smuggler of mostly illegal goods. If it turned out he was just smuggling tea bags, you know, it would have been like, and? So, Elite has a certain rule, a rule set to it, where it puts the tools in place for you to build a story for your character, because you are the character. And I think a lot of people on the forums, they're verbalizing the very thing I've been talking about for years now. And that is, there's the games that tell you what you need to know, or more precisely, what you want to know. And then there are the games that tell you what you need to know and leave the rest up to you. Okay? In some games, the game is what gives you a goal. The game gives you your purpose. The game tells you what your purpose is. Okay? The game tells you what you're supposed to do, what you have to do. The game tells you what direction you should be walking in, how fast you should be getting there, what you should be bringing with you, and what you're going to be doing when you get there. There are games that do that. A majority of games do that. They give you a start point, a journey, and a destination to work for, and it's all told to you. This is what you're going to be doing. And when you get to this, they're going to be fighting a boss. Your character's motivation is laid out for you in cutscenes. Your character's motivation is laid out for you in dialogue scenes. You are nothing more than the puppeteer of a puppet whose story was written by somebody else. Now, most people apparently find that type of gameplay fascinating and enjoyable or fun. Personally, I find it to be shallow. It's a shallow experience. In Elite, granted, the genre might not be your cup of tea. The setting, you know, it's a science fiction setting, might not be your cup of tea. That's fine. This is not about whether or not you like the game or not because of its aesthetics or because of its genre or because of its setting. We're talking about the interaction between the player and the world that it's being that's being built around it. Games like Elite, EVE Online, possibly even Star Citizen if it ever comes out, these games are built on the notion of giving the player the freedom and the responsibility of choosing their own path. And if you do not make a choice, you will go nowhere. You will do no thing. You will accomplish no thing. And I say no thing, not nothing. You will accomplish no thing. And I use that intentionally. A lot of players who complain about games like Elite or EVE complain because they have no mind of their own. They need to be told where to go. They need to be told what to do. They need to be told how to play. They need to pick a class. They need to have a role assigned to them. They need a scoreboard or an achievement sheet to follow. They need a path, a map of progression. And the progression map is one of the worst things that has come into newer games today.